So this is down the street from our office. No trespassing yet.
Pump track. Oh, I'm getting hurt here for sure.
Swapmoto line lunch stop right here. Less than a mile from the office.
Look at that.
I don't know, dude. I think, like, if I come here, little kids will throw rocks at me. Dude. I'm going to have to buy another pump track bike.
It's impressive. Look how steep that pump track is compared to this bike.
Yeah. Dude. I guess the important question is, what hospital's here?
Loma Linda is 5 minutes away.
Oh yeah, Dr. Bone works there.
Yeah, we'll be fine.
Oh, I'm sending it. When I was a kid, there was these, is there like comic books? It's called Ripley's Believe It or Not. And it was like strange facts, like unbelievable things like I don't know, like in Indonesia, there's a snake that can grow to 53 feet long and eat two humans. Stuff like that. I think it was like books or comic books, or it came in a bubblegum packet or something. But along those lines, Ripley's Believe It or Not, we are back at Glen Helen. My nemesis. The track where I sucked donkey weenie. And anyway. The Cowie guys are way over there breaking in their bikes. I think there's like eight of them breaking in eight 2023 KX450s. I'm sure they have a lot of blue tape. But Chase and I are here. We brought our KTMs today. So let's compare. Backyard Designs did my kit. And Chase designed his own kit with Backyard on their graphic builder. His obviously looks cleaner because it's new. I think he put the kit on last night. What do you like better? Chase's or mine? Anyhow, still in my loaner van from Umberto. I think I get mine back tonight. We got a set of graphics for the 350 Husky. Backyard stuff's super cool. It's hard to believe it comes from Germany in like 2 days. They send you this install kit with a squeegee. Don't really need the squeegee though. Their stuff goes on pretty easy. Got my O'Neill mountain bike shoes. Yeah. Wait for a beautiful day here. Later on today, we're going to Cowie to pick up a jet ski. I was talking to Chase because his latest ADD hobby is jet skiing. He bought a 550 that has a 650 engine crammed in it, and it's like some like project ski. But he went to Havasu for his birthday and I think the thing didn't run or something. So I was telling him I rode a stand up with my buddy Darren Nishimura back in the day, and I couldn't stand up for more than like 30 yards and I'd fall down and fall face first in the water and blow my contact lenses out of my head. He says new skis are easier to ride. So I asked Cowie if we could borrow one to play with it. So we're going to go to Cowie later today. To pick up a jet ski, and I'll eat shit on that too. We're here for the
2023. This is the best bike we've ever made, as we were just saying.
Of course it is. You didn't need any changes. Wait, can I see?
It's not just the handling, Brad. It's the power. Yeah,
this is the official tape of 2023. Can I say that my 1986 Kawasaki Takati, I painted the frame this color. It was sick. Blue and green. I mean, it was 1985. But it was the factory color. Jimmy White's three-wheeler was like that.
That's I think I told you we got one of those at the museum. You got to come check
you
out.
You won't let me ride it. I've been begging.
You can push it around a little bit.
No, I need to fire that up. Wait, Cha, why is...
That's a new shoe club. I've never seen.
You like that? You like that?
Crocs?
Yeah.
Adidas Crocs.
Those are heavy.
It's proof that your phone is listening to you, right?
Oh, you got it.
Because I was giving Hoppa Shiva his Crocs, and I'm all, it'd be cooler if they're like Adidas or something.
That's exactly.
And then the ad popped up on my Instagram. Wait, why do you have black?
Black what?
Black tape.
Oh, it's duct tape.
I know, but...
It's a little reinforcement.
Huh?
It's... We're reinforcing the tape.
It really grips the bike when it rides.
Okay.
That's right.
So wait, you have black over the blue?
Yeah.
So like your bike's a bruise, black and blue?
It is a bruise. It's a big bruise.
Why do you tape the frame? You could just put Scotch-Brite on it.
On the foot pegs, too? That's nice. Yes. You do
everything. Kind of the foot pegs.
Keep the tech guys happy.
Did you bring your ride gear? We could use a body. Robert?
Yeah, you ride Cowies today? I'll keep my bike clean.
I'll keep the bike clean.
Dude, all you need is 1 hour.
Okay. Is this like the staff field trip?
Like, well, this is like we're bonding.
Everyone gets a ride today.
This is our bonding day.
Yeah. So how much, you try to put an hour on every bike?
Yeah, we put an hour on every bike.
Look at all the 21s. Well, this is where all the magazine bike plastic goes to die.
This is a graveyard.
Huh?
Magazine plastic graveyard.
Yeah. Let's see, who's there? Dirt Rider. Who's Giroud?
You're lucky you get two numbers.
French guy. Jerome.
Oh, that's a vital guy.
That's a vital guy? A lot of skirt rider stickers. Cycle News. Why would Cycle News make both their bikes 21?
Anderson.
Big all
big fans.
Yeah.
Oh, this is a Pingree bike. Who's 414?
Not sure.
He's got the sparkles,
it's
too.
Me today.
Eddie Ayala, 414.
Got the sparkles out today.
Oh, why do you put the tape over the MXA logo? Let's see, is that under there?
Why do you think?
Yeah, I do that too.
No swap plastics, your bikes come back so nice and clean, we don't want to even use those plastics.
Yeah,
they're so cherry.
It's new kit day today, but I want to show you guys this thing. Alpine Stars makes a bicycling bib for downhill mountain biking. So it's obviously got the butt pads, but it's got a little bit of padding in the hips. When you get old like me, you gotta protect your hips because you fall down and break a hip. But I like it for this thing. It's a D3O foam pad that covers your spine. Been kind of conscious of protecting my spine ever since my brother broke his back. But yeah, I wear this under my riding gear. And also when I mountain bike at the park. But it's new kit day today. 2023 O'Neill stuff. This is black and white camo. Highlight color is brown. They give me brown numbers. Dookie Brown Mayetta 48. Pants are sick. Ethica socks, of course. Man, I hope I don't hit the ground today. So we also have this thing charging. Little Manscaped lawnmower. Scrub Daddy, on text last night, agreed to let me shave his head today. So the plan is to shave the top of his head so he looks like Bozo the Clown, and then say that it died. Make him go home that way.
Yeah. Dude.
Well, I have to say it because I've been vlogging all morning. I have to say what happened.
I'm pretty pissed, dude.
So, Not riding today because my new kit, size 30 pants. The green ones I wore at Paris Sunday fit. The black ones, I think they're like 28s. I couldn't even zip them up. Bummer. Guess I get to work today.
It's like a 26, right?
I smell cologne. I smell cologne that like male models wear. Oh, it's Trevor.
That's not cologne. That's VP.
VP? Are you sure you're not wearing some fancy like model guy cologne?
I don't, you know me.
When you passed me last week, I swear I smelled like Calvin Klein CK1 or something.
No, it was some new unreleased stuff that I've been working on.
Versace cologne?
I don't know. I don't want to tell the moto community. You know, they don't like it anyway, so it's all good. What up, Don? Another Tuesday.
Can you believe I'm here again?
I don't know.
I
man.
Suck here, dude.
I don't think so. I think you think you suck here.
No, I'm terrible.
And then that causes you to push the front end and everything.
Did you see that video with Soy? You know what? You know what caused that? That fucking tire.
What tire was it?
The MX-14, the scoop tire.
Yeah.
It doesn't slide. It hooks up.
I don't know. Are they just like a rear tire?
It's a rear tire.
Okay, yeah, gotcha. Yeah.
But it hooks up so good. I've never gone up the hills as fast.
Really good. There's this new trend now that the pros started, like,
scoop tire.
Let's run a scoop tire everywhere. Yeah. And then you come out to Glen Helen on a Tuesday and you're like, let's never touch that thing again.
That's good on the start and the up there.
Oh, I bet.
So I was going through that turn and I'm like, there was no berm at the end. So yeah. I went to clutch it to slide.
Right.
And it hooked up and I lifted the front end and fell on my face. And of course, Scrub Daddy got on film,
dude,
right?
Not again. Yeah, I've been seeing him out here a ton too. What's up with that?
But he comes out, but he doesn't ride.
He's just
scared of the bumps.
I would be too.
Huh?
I mean, after I seen videos of him at, where was that? Paris, I think. No, it was at Star West before it closed. That video of him where he whiskeys or some shit right when he lands and like, oh my
God. No, that was, he and I went to a race at, Kern County Raceway.
Oh shit!
Yeah, he ate shit right after the finish line.
he's too used to milestones though.
Yeah.
Know? But yeah. So Tuesday.
Okay, so what's the latest? Are you're still on this Pervines?
Yep, Pervines Yamaha.
Pervines Yamaha.
Same old thing. It's good, man. It's good. We got the rest of the series to do, so we get the summer off, and then from September.
What, do they take a break because it's too hot?
Yeah, because half
off-road's
of our races.
Too gnarly, huh?
I think so. We've done them before. We went to Mesquite in 2020 when COVID was going on, and we showed up and it was practice day is 112, and we're okay, we get to race 2 hours tomorrow. Yeah. So yeah, we get the summer off now.
How are you doing in the first half?
We were good. I was sitting second in works coming into that. There's a Vegas round, which is kind of an enduro cross,
mm-hmm.
and then three turns in, just such a freak thing. First time it ever happened to me, I snapped a chain. I landed off a roller and I went from eighth to third in three turns. It was gonna be good and then it went horrible.
Aww.
So that, and then had mishaps. I KO'd myself at the big six round after that, or the NGPC one, and then so I went from being in a title hunt to so far out of it.
Aww.
So yeah, now it's gonna be fun. Now we're working on some other things. I think I'm gonna do straight rhythm this year.
Sick.
Off-road
Building
guy.
A future up.
Full off-road nice. Guy. Gonna go.
Are we gonna see you at Paula Racing National?
We're thinking about it.
You should.
Yeah, I know. I want to. I think I could do it. I mean, I'm coming off an injury still, so got worked here after Talladega. Just lost the front end before the roller. Go look at that on my Instagram. It was fun. So little things, but just working off-road next year. Hopefully some more little things going on. Maybe I could tell people in another time. But should be fun.
Cool. Well, don't run over me today.
I won't. We'll have fun.
You always yell when you pass me. I like that.
Actually, Will's on his way out here right now.
Who?
Mr. Decker.
Decker's coming?
Decker's parking right here.
Nice. You're Enzo guy. Sick.
Tell your brothers.
Nice. All right, we're at Swap's Barbershop. We got the Manscaped Lawnmower 3.0.
Turn around.
Yep. Gonna use it on his head.
Let's go, homie. This ain't nothing.
Let's go. Dang, it's been too many years.
Manscaped is for shaving your nuts. So since he's a nuthead.
Come on, man.
Oh shit, it's working.
Yeah, because that's that good hair.
Okay, I want that moving pad when you guys are done with it.
Man, this is like 80 years.
You're glistening now. You're glistening.
You should have done a fucking mohawk first.
Wait, no, no, no.
Now a reverse. You did, you
oh, wait, shit, the battery died.
Yeah, right.
Oh, fuck. Oh, that's fucked up.
The battery died.
Those things don't last that long.
That's the battery died.
Yeah, right.
He's lying. I don't know. That's only for a set. Dude, that's only for a bunch of balls. That's it.
Hey, kiddos, it's Krusty the Clown. He said the battery died. He lied.
The battery died, man.
It's only for one use. One set of balls, and then it fucking dies.
Chase and I are at Kawasaki.
It's like Christmas Day.
We're picking up a jet ski. What's it even called?
1500 SXR.
A 1500cc four-stroke stand-up jet ski.
Four-cylinder.
Four cylinders? Dude. So yeah, so Chase has this jet ski obsession, and I was thinking I haven't ridden one since I was in my 20s, and I couldn't stand up then, and I probably can't stand up now, but...
You're far more agile.
Older, because I'm older. Yeah.
You told me to search your...
Security's big time thing here at Kawasaki Motors.
Gates.
Security gates.
The Berlin Wall is down.
We can see our gym over there waiting for us. Mm-hmm. She looks primed and ready to go.
No mixing gas.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm gonna need a call risk and get another.
Oh, another gas can, huh?
Yeah, because I can't.
You gonna see anything top secret back here? Probably not. There's some mules.
Oh, that looks familiar.
Hey, that thing was in 1,000 pieces at the shop the other day. There she is. There's no wheels on it, dude.
There's wheels on the trailer.
There's four wheels. It's life on two wheels. This thing looks like injury on the water, drowning. Dude, maybe I'll work on my farmer's town.
Yeah, that's what they're for.
Dude, it's huge.
It's really big.
This is way bigger like than your, it's way bigger than the 440 I rode last.
Yeah.
Maybe we could call, should I call Slasher, have him come out with us?
We should.
Or Jacobs, the jammer?
That'd be some clickbait.
Well, you know what? You know that Hayden Maeda kid that used to race our series and her mom that I rode mountain bikes with? Mm-hmm. She was like women's expert national champion.
No way.
Yeah, we should get her out. Yeah. And Hayden's dad now is, he was her mechanic or someone's mechanic on
the
team.
Heck?
Yeah.
Interesting.
I'll just have him be my proxy. That's a Maeda that could ride a ski, not me.
Yeah, but it's so much fun. You guys will have a blast.
John, can you ride one of these?
Oh, yeah.
It's yeah?
What I really, really enjoy, the old style, the stand-up, but the newer one for the four-stroke, it's just so much fun.
Is it easier to ride than the two strokes of yesteryear?
I'd say they're about the same, but this one
I didn't
is really easy.
See,
you're going to be up on it before you know it.
The only time I've ridden jet skis is like a 440 in the ocean. And I used to just fall on my face after like 20 yards and blow my contact lenses out of my eye.
I wear my contacts and have no problem with this.
Well, you probably have skill and balance.
Oh, you've got skill and balance.
We'll see. Have you seen me ride a mountain bike? You don't know about my lack of
skill. I've seen a couple of videos of you riding and everything. It looks pretty cool. You ride better than I do on a mountain bike, that's for sure, and everything. But you're going to have fun, this thing with the tray and everything. Mm-hmm. One thing you will notice is you literally can just stand up on it right in the water.
And it I think floats instead.
They all, yeah, they float.
No, I'm just saying, you can balance on it, stand there?
It's so balanced, you don't have to have it on.
Huh. Yeah, I think.
Okay, well, that's a plus.
I think my biggest problem with you is could be getting it back.
Maybe.
And we know where you live.
Well, we're going to put a lot of content out so that we justify the loan.
That's good. You know, as we need that.
The extended loan. Hey, look at this.
Ralston McGrath.
Look at this. Yeah. I bet you there's some teeth marks in this from my face. Blam! Smashing into that.
So now you're going to have a lot of fun.
So John, tell me, sir, what this thing is. This is a SXR.
Yep.
Like 1000 something.
It's the new one stickers have it called the SXR 160 and everything.
Uh-huh. 160?
Yeah.
So it's only 160 cc's?
No.
1600. Yeah.
Close to that.
They just drop one of the zeros?
Pretty close. But anyhow, it's going to be something that you're going to just really, really enjoy. Mm-hmm. You know, it's the stand-ups are, you know, what started it all and everything. Yeah. And the time you'll spend on this, and what you'll learn is you'll start doing more and more, you know, different cutting and everything, and just learning on it. You'll have a great time with it.
Can you turn real tight and drag your foot in the water?
I can.
You can?
Yeah. You'll be doing it.
No way.
Yes. I will see videos.
That's the stuff I used to see Slasher doing.
Slasher. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And then, you know, Katamori from here, one of our mm-hmm. racers and mm-hmm. everything, and watching him, you know, and his wife.
Do you remember Nao Maeda?
Yeah.
The mechanic?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm buddies with him.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow, it's a small world and everything.
Yeah, so I told Chase just now, I'm going to have Nao ride, and he'll be the Maeda stand-in.
That's going to be the trick, is we'll get him used to this, and then we'll throw him on the 440 or the 550.
Yeah, then right I'll after. Just eat shit.
I can't remember the movie, but Tomb Raider, I think it was. My friend played Angelina Jolie in that.
Oh, really? Yeah?
Yeah. But he had to put a ponytail on and everything.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's funny.
And it was really neat because he said they had another guy they had hired from Hollywood, didn't do so well.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
But then they hired him.
Yeah.
And he got to talk with her a ton, just said how nice she was.
Really?
And he taught her how to ride it and everything. Wow. Here's this movie star that's worth just a few shellings and pennies and everything, or yen or whatever.
Yeah.
But he said she couldn't have been any nicer, but he did all the stuff for Tomb Raider.
That's
nice.
Hey, I have a question. Why are there like headlights facing your face?
Stuff we're gonna go over.
Oh, this is the warning lights and shit, right?
Yeah. I gotta go find out where he put the key.
Takes a key?
Yeah. So let me go get Bobby real quick.
Okay.
Or let me see if I can text him.
John, is there any chance we could get in the museum and I could sit on that 1986 Takati KXT 250?
Yes.
Oh, you just made his day. You know, he had a bad day. He showed up to the track and couldn't ride.
Why couldn't you ride?
Because the gear didn't fit.
What?
So I got new sets of gear, and I wore one Saturday, and I brought the other today, and the set I brought today didn't fit.
Oh.
But I got to shave Scrub Daddy's head. So
hey, okay. But I did hear one of our guys forgot his gear here.
Oh, one of the breaking guys?
Yeah.
Yeah, we saw them. We saw the tape festival out there.
Brett,
we're entering hallowed ground right now.
Dude, that thing's actually sick.
I see it. The object of my desire. Look at that thing, dude. Come on.
It's actually pretty cool.
Tell me that's not sick.
Look at the shrouds.
Yeah, this is the first year that they relocated the shrouds on the tank.
Wow. What is it, a 250? Yeah.
Yeah.
Dude. What the heck?
Look at this thing. Oh, this one's an 87.
Yes.
Came on 86.
Yes.
Here, get.
Hard.
Come on, John. I'll give you every shootout win for the next 4 years.
Somebody else wants to buy it. This guy right here will say,
"Hey, there's no fluid in the front brake, though."
Yeah.
Heck yeah. Oh, if I can, my life's complete. I can die happy then. All right, the KTM free ride intro. Free ride. Free ride used to be a two-stroke, right?
Yep.
Now it's electric?
Now it's electric.
How long has it been electric?
They've had it, I think, for 10 years.
Electric for 10 years?
Yeah. They're going to tell you that. But it's been around for about 10 years.
Because I saw someone at the Singapore race on a free ride that had dual exhaust.
Yeah.
But so it, that was 11 years old?
No, no, no. I think they made those in tandem.
Oh, okay.
They had an
okay.
E, and I think, if I remember correct, they had an E, and then they had a, you know, a
yeah.
motor. Like, it was just called a Freeride 2. Basically, it was a Freeride 2-stroke.
Mm-hmm.
But then they've had this generation now for a while.
So I told Marvin I was going to have one for a little while.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, we can go ride on the golf course.
Oh, cool. It'll be fun.
Yeah.
Hazard strap?
No.
No news. No news. No.
How was Loretta?
Yes. It had its ups and downs.
What was the up? What was the highest up?
The highest up was running top five for a moto.
Nice.
That was good.
I saw a post where you had the same lap time as Deegan.
Yep. Yep.
I don't know about that.
I don't know about that. But it was there. It was close. Yeah.
It was there?
Yeah.
Were your lap times faster
yeah.
than his?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Woo!
Oh, yeah.
Has the torch been passed?
Oh, yeah. It's done.
It has?
Yeah.
Like,
full time.
You conceded. Full
yeah,
time.
I'm out. Yeah. I'm retired. I'm full time dad now.
Yeah. Nothing's 100% universal in this world, so.
Yeah. So if this has a 220, like you said, usually at the Tesla charger stations, they'll have a 220 that you can.
Just a plug, just an outlet?
Yeah, but I think the
so this is the new KTM headquarters. When's this supposed to be done?
It should be done like end of the year, moving in
that
a
quick.
Few months after.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Now, will they hire a moving company to move everything, or employees
I hope so.
Have to come in on the weekend?
I hope we get a little help.
Yeah, I would hope
yeah.
so.
All right, so on this campus, it's 18.5 acres. There's three buildings, a parking lot with 290 parking spots. So this will be the motorsports building. It's the biggest building on the campus. It's roughly, I believe, 71,000 square feet. This will be the front entrance. You'll have visitor parking here. The employees will pass through there. It's all in the front, motorsports. It'll be all racing, R&D, and WP for the time being now. And we can enter in. You'll see the pod offices for all those employees that will work in motorsports racing.
Looking good. We got matching headwear
yeah.
styles.
So these are all the.
Look at Mr. Jordy Torres. So are you gonna steal his new mountain bike as soon as he gets it?
No, I got one that's sick.
Yeah? Yeah. He was a cross country too?
Yeah.
Don, you got any extra gloves?
Yeah, that's actually how I came
here. Maybe in my van. I gotta go back to my van because I only brought one knee pad.
Oh really?
Yeah.
I got some extra knee pads.
No, if I, because the truck's not too far from the parking lot, right?
Yeah.
I'm just gonna go down.
Oh,
if I have gloves, there? I'll grab them free.
Okay.
Oh. Rach, that thing was staring me in the face. Yeah.
After the wood, I have not cleared that next year.
After the wood step down?
Here?
No, like further down. After the
where there's the two rollers and
yeah. No.
No.
After the wall rides, and then you have the two jumps, and then you have the big berm, and there's the wood thing. That next jump, I don't know why I like tap my brake.
After the wood one?
Yeah.
Have you done the very last one?
Yeah.
It's smaller than that.
I know. I don't know how to do. I'll just follow somebody.
I'll tell you
don't
if you want.
Don't follow me. Okay. You guys, I'll go behind you.
Thank you.
Yeah, you got it. It's got the bubble lens. It's not, it's like, not that close. Like
you might see my zit on my face right here.
So, pro enduro racer, mm-hmm. pinup model, mom, race promoter.
Yeah, that's a new title.
So, is that why you're up here so much right now? Is because you're getting ready for Straight Acre Slalom?
Yeah, we are hosting another race here. So, it's August 19th through the 21st. Another dual slalom race and super pumped.
Is it kind of cool having it here after creating it at home? And it was a product of COVID, right?
Yeah, honestly, having it at home was so cool, but also like so stressful because it's in your own home, it's your environment. The liability aspect is a huge one in California, well, in the US. But the fact that Snow Summit is so gracious and interested in hosting the event with us, I don't know, we couldn't think of a better place to have it because it's close enough to home where we're not like traveling for weeks at a time. And then we get to see family. My dad lives up here. Kyle's uncles live up here. And yeah, it's a good time.
Chicken Matasevich?
No. Never heard of that guy.
Look at this guy. You know that ain't gonna help.
Hey, wait. No.
You putting race gas in a stock Honda.
Mm-hmm.
That don't make it run any better.
Look, how about that helmet? I'm looking for helmets already, see?
Yeah, I'm gonna get you a helmet.
How about that one?
Oh. Yeah, we're trying to give away some Z1R helmets today.
Is that a good one? Because every time I ask, you'd be like, no, that's a better one.
Oh, we gotta find the people on the vet track. But wait.
Is that
really VP put in there, or is that just the cam?
Just the cam.
I got a flaw somehow.
So, do you need a gas can? I get you a gas can.
Yeah, if you got a gas can. Because I had the race, I put mixed gas in the other one.
Okay. So that was just posing.
Yeah.
I see you at the gas station putting 91 in the BP can. Hey, so how are you liking this one?
This bike is too good. Huh? You're going to see it today. Watch. You know how
I see it? I'll see it like this. I'll see it like this. Where's he at? Where's he at? Oh, he's back there.
Hey, nuh-uh.
Hey, put the lid on.
What lid? Oh, I feel like with the gold rims, I feel like the king. King McGrath.
Oh, yeah?
Yep, back when
you
he
kicked
like
the muffler
this.
In yet?
No, they don't. You're right. They did make it stronger.
It's stronger.
It's way stronger.
I've been trying to kick it, huh?
I've been doing it. And I looked the other day when I watched something, I'm like, oh, it really did make it stronger.
Oh shit, look at Beto's bike.
It looked good, I ain't gonna lie. But hey, you know what I was thinking? How about he put a yellow seat with the ribbons? That'd be good.
That might look good, huh? Yep. Yellow seat.
With that yellow, ooh, that'll look good.
Yellow with gray ribs.
Yep, ooh, that'd be sick.
What color ribs?
From SDG?
No, put a yellow seat cover on, might look good.
That'll look awesome. You might even have Malcolm Stewart doing that.
Hey, you see a picture of Malcolm going over the bars?
It's
It's good for you. It's like your it's like the Suzuki, right?
I liked the Honda last year, but I was so fast on it, the owner of it didn't want me to keep standing.
Oh shit.
And it had number 5. A lot of people was mixing me up. They thought Dungey came out of retirement and got on.
I thought I were Ben LeMay. I thought you
Well
had,
they thought I was Trey Canard the other day, so you know.
At first I thought it was Trey, and then I saw it was like, fuck, is that Ben? I'm back on a Honda? No, it's not Ben. It's fucking scrubbing.
You're all, oh damn, Ben been living the good life. Look at that stomach.
Yeah. But the bike is good.
And he's wearing fly again, so that shot that down.
So Cooney, how is how's the track? I know it's our favorite place right now.
It's been a little struggle with the heat and the wind. It's gotten blown out, but we stayed out here late last night. We were out here till about 11:30. We put about 8,000 gallons of water on the track last night.
Yeah.
And hopefully we're gonna be good today.
Nice.
So, but we're looking forward for it to cool down a little bit and get into that October, November, December and get this place rolling and get this place back.
Oh shit, there's some tracks that closed down for the summer, right?
Yeah.
That homie up there, Cal City, closes it down because it's too hot.
I've seen that even LACR, they only doing like mostly rentals because nobody goes.
Yeah. So it's good. It's a learning process, but I think we're making the right decisions, and you know we're open 4 days a week now, which is working out for us. It's helping us, you know, with fuel and labor and things like that. So we'll just keep
grinding.
Just keep grinding, man. That's what we're doing out here. Appreciate all the support, everyone. Ryan Parrish.
What's wrong with this guy?
I love this guy.
Excited,
what can I say?
Man, I'm ready to go. I get to ride with my buddies.
Showed up. Getting bigger.
She is.
I hope she's done growing right now.
Thank you.
podcast.